Today is quite a dreary day. Lots of rain.
Yeah.
But this is always a day brightener.
All right, guys, that's all you're getting. I'm soaked. So guys, it's a wet, rainy day here in New York, but we got a nice warm shop. And you know how it always changes, right? We had, what, two or three Peterbilts in here? Well, now there's three Kenworths. And all these trucks are getting services. Some of these trucks, like this truck, is actually a spare truck. And so our spare trucks come in every 3,000 miles because different drivers run them. The other trucks are scheduled for every 5,000 miles. So that one is 3,000 mile service. This is a 5,000 mile service. This is actually one of the new ones with the red motor. Unfortunately, I gotta head out. I gotta hook up to the trailer and go grab some stuff with the trailer and then stop back in. And I got a visitor coming today. Going into my office, I see this every single day. One of the most important things is loving your job. You gotta love what you do. The cool thing I just found on Facebook is that the Louisville Truck Show is scheduled for next March, and it's the big 50th truck show. So hopefully we can go, and hopefully something else. Y'all should see the trailer I'm about to pull. I hate when they do this. They unhook the trailer and it's not high enough. I can't get my truck under. I gotta crank this thing up like a foot. Who does that? Just not gonna fit. Okay, that looks better. Guys, this salesman stopped in. He hooked me up with a hack. Anyway, we're talking about truck show, a few different things, working on some things, got some things hashed out, so stay tuned. Well, guys, it's still raining here. A dreary day all day long. We had a few little spots of sun, but unfortunately, this is the time of the year for some of the rain here in upstate New York. So tomorrow morning, I got to head out early, and I'll show you the truck I'll be driving.
It is a 2019 Kenworth.
This truck I'm going to be running is a 2019 Kenworth W900. It's got a 500 Cummins X15 Performance Series with a 13-speed transmission and 373 rears, 62-inch aero cab flat top, and I don't know what else you want to know. Rolling out, guys. So, like I said in one of my previous videos, it's kind of a busy time of the year. We got everything kind of coming to head, and then things will be slowing down. Usually December, January, and February
our slowest months. So I'm just pulling out. I don't have anything to mount this camera on the windshield, but I'll show you when we arrive at the spot of delivery. I'm heading east this morning. Guys, the other unique thing that I'm hauling is I'm hauling a load of bricks, and I'm hauling them on a walk-in floor. And I don't know if you guys ever hauled bricks in a walk-in floor, but it's not quite what you think it is. I'll show you when I swing the doors open. You ready to see the brick fall out? And probably it is different for most of you guys just pulling a van trailer. You just got one lock rod. So these trailers have two lock rods. Just there's a lot of weight that gets up against the back doors. But this morning there is no weight up against the back doors. So believe it or not, this is a palletized load. And I don't know if you guys are familiar with hauling pallets on a walk-in floor. These trailers are designed for the weight. So the guy hauled a load of wood chips, I think, prior. You can see a couple of them here. And then he backed in to a dock, reloaded with palletized stone. And I think there's some brick up there as well. Guys, I don't back into docks a whole lot, so I always want to be a little careful. It looks like we're lined up pretty good. Looks a little better. We gotta get this load unloaded fast. Guys, I'm here to get loaded, and I gotta pop a tarp out. Ready out, so I'm good. That's a good thing. Huh, we won't say what happened here. Anyway. There's a sweep tarp that clips in. If you can see the clamp right there, it's got several clamps that hold a sweep tarp in. And I think you've seen in some of the other previous videos what a sweep tarp does. It just keeps that floor nice and clean. You don't have so much sweeping when you empty it out. This load of chips is actually gonna get tipped off. So it's gonna go up on a big tipper, and he's just gonna load the chips right in here, and we'll be out of here. Product we're loading here today is wood chips. Not many times do I compliment a loader operator, but this guy did a phenomenal job. I just want to walk up here in the load and show you guys. So a lot of times, you know, the load's off centered or crooked, you gotta get up there and fork. And even like this stuff on the edge, I really won't even have to brush this off, but I'm going to. Guy did a great job, packed it in and everything. see down that trailer. Just a nice even load. So you can see these straps now. What they do is hold the tarp up. So this trailer, or almost all of our walk-in floors, only have two crossbows in the trailer. And we do that just so, like you saw, this guy coming in with the loader, he can come in and he can pack the loads in a little bit. We'll get a little more on. Otherwise, it gets heaped up and then there's a lot of forking and we just don't get the payload on. So that's why there's no crossbows in the center. There's just two. It's usually enough to fit most size buckets right in the middle. And then that lets us, so when it rains or whatever else, these straps are tight and it's supposed to shed the water. Not always does that happen. Sometimes, you know, our arches on our trailers are not quite high enough, but most times it works well. All tarped. So guys, maybe just something else about this sawmill. It's kind of interesting. I was around when this sawmill started and you can see it has grown quite a bit. I'm on the back side of the mill, the chip bin and the bark bin, the sawdust bin, the log yard. So way back in, I would say early 2000s, maybe 98, in that range, we were hauling mulch and we manufactured mulch. And that was back when we owned the mulch business. So we would haul bark out of this mill. Before he was actually here, he was maybe 10, 15 minutes away at another location. We hauled out of there. I remember hauling out of here when I was a kid, and we've been hauling out of here ever since. So I know the owner personally. He's a great guy to work with, and it's good to come back here. It's been probably a couple years since I was here, so it's good to come back and see how much this place has grown and all what they're doing. So yeah, just a small operation that went big. Obviously it's not as big as some mills, but definitely decent size. One other thing I want to point out too is you can see our trucks. You know, sometimes you think, you just get one of those low pro trucks, you know, better fuel economy, on and on. Well, you can see the mud over there and you can see what I'm dealing with here. You know, I obviously, to come around this corner, I had to go into this puddle and I got to pull up around the buildings and back out on the road. Time to hit the road.
The other thing is I never met that loader operator before, at least not that I know of. I don't know if he ever seen me in here before, but I don't remember seeing him. And he doesn't know who I am. He doesn't know that I've been coming here years and years. The other thing is I told him about our channel and he's gonna check it out. And guys, there's only 17% of you guys subscribed. I know I haven't really been telling you to subscribe on every video, but there's only 17% subscribed of my viewers. That means you better hit that subscribe button, please. Thank you. I'm back. Gotta find a spot to park this thing. We'll go take a walk to the shop, see what they got going on in there, and close out this video.
Got some services we're working on again. What are you working on here? Service? Uh-oh, temperature check. Here's another service. This trailer. I was just looking at it. This one has disc brakes, SAF axle,
and see that 215, 292.
Are how many miles that are on this first set of pads?
That is what I love about disc brakes. And this thing does haul heavy as well.
Getting some new rubbers.
Alrighty guys, that'll do it. Thanks a lot for watching. Peace out.